This is lesson 2 in the Talkback 101 series, and we're going to go over Talkback's back and forth gestures. Hi everyone, it's Carrie from Live Accessible. If you're new to Talkback, make sure to check out lesson 1, which I will link in the YouTube card and in the description below. Today we're going to go over Talkback's back and forth gestures, and to find a list of these gestures and more, check out the link in the description to my website where I have a list of every Talkback gesture available. There's a way to customize Talkback gestures, but we're going to go over all of the defaults that come built into Talkback. And if you're new here, welcome! We do videos on tutorials like this for Android, iOS, tips, encouragement for the blind, visually impaired, and their sighted supporters. Consider subscribing for more videos like this one. So let's go ahead and get started.
So here's my Nexus 6P and I'm on the home screen and I already have Talkback on. So for all of these gestures, use one finger and make sure you start the gesture as soon as your finger touches the screen and make sure you make it into one smooth movement. So think of these gestures as going in one direction and back in the direction that you started from. These gestures don't need to be perfect. They can kind of be in a shape of a V or a U. But what you do need to do is you have to do this motion quickly. And the first gesture is a swipe up and down. So I'm going to swipe up and down.
Google.
And it's going to take you to the first item on the screen. It's not going to take you to the notification bar. It's going to take you to the first thing in the app that is visible on the screen. So in this case, when I swiped up and down, it took me to the search bar on the home screen. So where this is useful is when you're in the middle of an app or in the middle of a list, you can immediately jump to the top. So you swipe up and down.
Search settings, out of list.
Right now I'm in settings, so it takes me to the search bar. It's also useful when you're in an app where the first thing on the screen is a navigation menu. So right now I have the Play Store open, and if you swipe up and down.
Show navigation drawer button, out of list.
It will take you right to the navigation menu, or sometimes it could be a back button. So this just makes a lot of things easier. The next gesture is swiping down and then up. So this is the opposite. This is taking you to the last item on the screen. Not the last item on a list, but what is visible on the screen. I find this really useful on YouTube. So if you are watching a video and you're also browsing on YouTube, it's difficult to get to the video at the bottom of the screen. There's some controls. So what I like to do is I swipe down and up.
Library button.
And it takes you
to. Double tap to activate.
And it takes you to the bottom of the screen. And in this app, that's library. And if you scroll to the left.
Inbox. Subscription.
Scrolling back.
Trend. Selected. Home. Expand mini player.
You can expand the mini player.
Close button.
Close it.
Play video button.
Or play it or pause
it. Double tap to activate.
If you're in the middle of browsing, and you know, if you keep swiping to the right, all it's going to do is scroll down in the page. Unless you take your finger and try to find where it is on the screen, which is difficult when you're totally blind and you're not sure where exactly it is. So this just makes it more accessible. This is also very useful in certain apps where there's a button at the bottom of the screen, and again, if you just swipe to the right, it's not going to take you to that button. So what you do is you just swipe down and up.
Compose button.
And I'm in Gmail right now, so it takes me to the Compose button. So this just makes it easier to go to certain buttons sometimes. The next gesture is a swipe right then left. So on the home screen, this can take you to the next page. Like this. Or to scroll back, you can use the gesture left right.
Home screen.
Now being in the settings, I can use the same gestures of swipe right then left to scroll down in the menu and swipe left then right.
Storage.
To scroll up the menu.
Double tap to activate.
You can also use these gestures to control sliders. For example, the volume slider. You can swipe right then left to increase
48%, 53%, 58% ring, seek control,
or
ringtone volume,
or swipe left then right to decrease
53, 48, 43, ringtone volume set to 40%,
You can use that gesture for a brightness slider or a speech rate slider. You can also use the volume up and down to control sliders, but certain apps get a little bit confused when you use the volume keys, and so this is an alternative to using the volume keys when it doesn't work. These gestures do take some time to get used to and some practice, so I would suggest just staying on the home screen and trying these gestures out.
So those are all the talkback back and forth gestures. The next video in this series will come out in about 2 weeks, and we are going to go over some angle gestures with talkback. So I have a question for anyone still watching. What is something that you struggle with using Android or talkback? Please leave that in the comments below and I might just do a video on that. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up below and don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell for more videos on how you can live accessible. Thanks for watching, everyone, and I will see you in the next one.